Hi. In many electronic circuits, using negative voltage is quite common. But have you ever wondered how we can generate negative voltage when we only have positive voltage available? The reality is that negative voltage does not really exist on its own. Negative voltage is essentially positive voltage, but with the reference or zero volt point in a different location in the circuit. To understand this better, think of negative voltage as just positive voltage, but with the zero volt point set at a specific position in the circuit. In today's video, we'll explore this topic and explain step by step how to produce negative voltage using a positive regulator. So let's take a look together. This is a positive voltage regulator, specifically the LM7805. This regulator provides a 5-volt positive output from the right pin. Any input voltage up to 40 volts can be used, and it will always output 5 volts. The left pin is for the input voltage. The middle pin is for ground, and the right pin is the output. You can use any voltage regulator, but the input voltage needs to be about 2 volts higher than the desired output to ensure proper operation. I've connected the regulator to a power supply. The left pin is connected to the positive voltage, and the middle pin is connected to ground. The power supply is set to 10 volts. Let's measure the voltages. Input voltage 10 volts. Ground and output. As you can see, the output is 5 volts. Now, to obtain both positive and negative voltages, we only need to set the reference 0 volt to the regulator output pin instead of the power supply. So, I'll place the negative probe of the multimeter on the output pin as the reference. Currently, we have 5 volts positive at the input and negative 5 volt at the power supply ground. There is no actual negative voltage here. We have just changed the reference point. Next, I'll use a 12 volt regulator. I'll replace the 5 volt regulator with the 12 volt one. To create equal positive and negative voltages, the power supply needs to be set to twice the regulator's voltage. So, I set the power supply to 20 volts, because the regulator is 12 volts. Let's measure again. First, I measure the input voltage. 20 volts. I place the negative probe of the multimeter on the regulator's output pin. Input voltage from the power supply, positive 12 volts. Power supply ground, negative 12 volts. Now, let's do a practical example. According to this schematic, I want to power an operational amplifier using both positive and negative voltages. The op amp is an LM4558. I am using this circuit to build a small amplifier. I'll connect the op amp's output directly to the speaker. We could also add a transistor to boost the sound if needed. Connect the positive voltage from the power supply to pin 1 of the regulator. Connect the negative voltage or 0 volts from the power supply to the middle pin of the regulator. The output pin of the regulator is the right pin, which gives us 12 volts. We use this pin as our reference or virtual 0 volts. Effectively acting as ground. Connect pin 8 of the IC to pin 1 of the regulator. Connect pin 4 of the IC to the middle pin of the regulator. We'll use this virtual ground for other connections. Connect the speaker to pin 1 of the IC. The other speaker wire goes to virtual ground, which is pin 3 of the regulator. Connect pin 3 of the IC to a 1 kilo ohm resistor to a virtual ground. connects pin 2 and one of the IC together using a 10 kilo ohm potentiometer. Adjusting this potentiometer will set the gain. The volume level isn't critical. Focus on the sound quality. To increase the volume, you could use a transistor or MOSFET at the op amp's output. But that's beyond the scope of this discussion. Connect the audio input through a coupling capacitor to pin 2. This capacitor is 10 microfarads. This pin is an inverting input. Non-inverting means the output signal will not be inverted. If the audio input were connected to the inverting pin, the output signal would be reversed. Now, I'll connect the audio signal and adjust the potentiometer to set the gain. I adjust the potentiometer. As you can see, the circuit works well. I put the schematic at the end of the video. Thank you for watching the video.